Hello students, welcome to Python online classes. Today I'm going to explain about the concept of strings. In Python, strings are also very important concept to know. So in this session I would like to explain how to create the strings and how to access the strings. Okay, so like that basic operation, some basic operations we have to access the strings. So all those things we can discuss now in this session. Okay, now let us start our session. Okay, right. So strings concept contain basic string operations, string slicing. For your understanding purpose, I am opening one Microsoft window. What are the concepts we have? Now we can see. Strings is the concept. Our today's concept is strings. In that, the first concept is basic string operations, string slicing. Basic string operations is the one of the concept. Basic string operations. Next, string slicing, testing, searching. String slicing, searching, testing, and manipulating strings. Manipulating strings. So according to our syllabus, these are the strings concepts. These are the strings concept we have to know. Now, first we have to see the basic string operations. Basic string operations. So, basic string operations. Now we have to know. How to create the string first? If you want to create any string, actually what is string? A string is nothing but a collection of characters, and a string is nothing but a group of characters or a collection of characters. If you arrange in a proper order, then you will get one valid string. Now we have to see the how to create the string. So str is the variable in that. Now I am storing the value, string value. So here I want to store my name, Shiva. So this word is called string because of this string contains a collection of characters. Here four characters all together, it will generate one proper value. It will generate one proper string. Am I correct or not? So actually here we are treating that string value is these four characters as a value of one string variable. So if you want to create any string, we need to follow this syntax. We have to follow this syntax. So compulsory, either single quote characters or double quote characters we can use. Single quotes also valuable. If you want to store any string in between single quotes, either double quotes. If you want to use anything, then you can use, no problem. But if you start with single quote, then compulsory need to close end of the string, same character, same single quote. Here, this is right. This is correct syntax. And now I am creating one more string. And this is also valuable. Because of a string, we can configure in between a single quotes or in between a double quotes. So this is also a valid correct syntax to declare a string. And one more I am defining for your understanding purpose here. Now I am starting one single character, same value I am assigning this, and ending double quotes. So this is invalid. This is invalid. Invalid. These two are valid. These two strings are syntaxes are valid syntaxes, but the last one is invalid because of the quote starts with single and ends with double quotes. So this is not a valid syntax. Understand? If you want to store a group of characters, or if you want to store a word or a string, string is nothing but a group of characters or a collection of characters. It may be a single word or it may be a sentence. In between double quotes, we need to configure. And after that, we need to store in one variable. So like that, we can create string. We can create strings. And practically, I am showing. For that, I am opening one command prompt. So through command prompt, I am opening Python shell window. So it has connected. Python shell window has connected. Now I am creating one string. For that I am creating one more variable, college underscore name. So this is variable name. In this I am storing college name G Pulla Reddy degree and PG college. So this is my string. I want to store this entire string. I want to store this entire string into college name variable. So is this right or not? Now we have to see. For that I am pressing enter key. So it is showing one error, invalid syntax. Why? So if you want to store any string values in any variable, if you want to store string values in any variable, compulsory we must need to use single quotes, or either single quotes or double quotes. But here I haven't used anyone. I haven't used anything. Single quotes also now I haven't used it, and double quotes also I haven't used it. So that's why Python compiler showing invalid syntax. Understand? Invalid syntax. So again, I want to save that name. I want to store that value into this one. And a small modification I am doing. Carefully observe here. Here I am going to save. I am going to use one single quotes. And end of the line also, I am closing with single quotes. Now it is a valid syntax. So now the college name, G Pulla Reddy degree and PG college, has stored in college name variable. Understand? College. Now I want to see that value is stored or not. That value has stored or not. Now I am checking. How I have to check? So directly I am using the print function. Print. In between print functional brackets. So what is the variable I have? Sorry, first I am copying this one. I am copying this one. College name. copied. So now I'm using the print function. Print functional brackets. In between these two functional brackets, I am pasting the college name variable. So now I am pressing enter key in my keyboard. So that value it is printing na. G Pularity degree and PG college has printed. If you use the variable name, it will print the value of variable, not variable name. It will not print which is the value it has stored in that variable. So that value it will print. Here our value is what? G Pularity degree and PG college. So if you use this one instead of this one, it will print the value of this one. So here the value is G Pularity degree and PG college. So like this type of strings we can store by using single quotes or double quotes. Understand? Again, double quotes I am using and my name. So in between double quotes, Shiva I am using. I have used Shiva. Now I am pressing enter key. So print name is the variable name. So that value it will print here. So like that, if you want to store any string values, compulsory either we have to use single quotes or double quotes. Understand? Without these two characters, single quotes or double quote characters, without these two things, you haven't any chance to store any string values. So for example, I want to store one hall ticket number. Hall ticket number is equal 10891940500001 is hall ticket number. So I am pressing enter key. So it is not showing any error because of it is a number. So if you want to store any numbers, single quote characters and double quote characters not required. But if you want to store a group of characters or a single character, we must have to use single quotes or double quotes. That is the difference between strings and numbers. Understand? For the string value purpose, we no need to use any single quotes or double quotes. But for the string characters purpose, for the strings purpose, we must have to use single quotes or double quotes. Anyone we can use. No problem. Compiler can accept. So like that, we can create the strings. So now you can understood na? You have understood how to create the strings. Now, what are the basic string operations we have? Now let us see. Now I want to access a string value. Accessing the individual characters in a string. So that is the concept now. Now we have the string word, nothing but a college name. G Pularity degree and PG college. So that entire string we can print by using variable name. So now I don't want to print entire string. I want to print some individual characters. Now I want to access individual characters. So how it is possible? By using for loop function. By using for loop technique, we can access the individual characters in a string. So that is also I would like to explain with practically. So for that I am opening one notepad window. So here, college name, college underscore name. So this is my variable. In this double quotes, I am storing the value G Pularity degree and PG college. So now I am closing the quotes, double quotes. So now I have created one string with the, after creation of this entire string, now this entire string I am assigning with the college name variable by using is equal to operator. Okay, so college name, here college name is the variable. and G polarity degree and PG college, which is enclosure with double quotes. So that is the value of college name. So this is property and this is the value. This is college name is the variable and this is the variable value. This entire string is called a variable value. Understand? Because of it is a string, that's why we have configured with double quotes. Next, I am accessing individual characters. First, I want to print entire string. So for that, simply I can use the print function. That variable name directly I am using. So the print function, it will print the entire string in the single line. So, and next, I don't want to print entire string. I want to print a single character. I want to print single characters. So character wise, I want to access the entire string. Okay. So for that, for loop I am using. For I is the index choosing value in. So that college name I am just copying and pasting because of the I variable will search into this variable. So here one colon symbol required. After that, one space character must and should be required in the next line. Then only the print function is completely belongs to for loop. Print I. So first it will search here I value. I is what? Searching index. So first in what variable college name is the variable. So here college name variable value is what? G polarity degree and PG college. So first I is placed in the first location, nothing but zeroth position. So now I am opening Excel file. So how index is locating? Now we can see G dot space PULLA like that. So and I mean for your understanding purpose, simply I am telling here. So that's why I am not showing complete string. Okay. So the index is first placed here, and after that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Understand? Like this, like index is pointing to that string value. So here G after G, one full stop is there, na? So that is also one of the special character, and after that I given one space. So this space is also occupying 1 byte of memory here. This space is also will occupy one index space here. So that's why G full stop one space. Next continued P U L L A. So remaining string I haven't configured. Just from here to here I would like to explain because of this is a very lengthy string. So it is not visible. So that's why it is not visible. Every time I want to, I need to move this from this side to that side. That's why. So simple word I have taken here. If you want to place that one also, I mean ready, pulla ready degree and PG college, then like this you can place. And index is also continue from next onwards. 7, 8. Like that. So I is first placing in 0 because of here the iteration is starting from first index now. So college name contain is what? So these many characters, how many characters we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. So 34 times it will iterate because of for loop functionality is what? How many times we have configured? that many times it will iterate by the for loop only. So by using for loop we can iterate number of times. We can iterate number of times. So first I is placing in the g position, nothing but 0th position. In 0th position g value we have. So like that. After that it will place in the full stop. I mean in the next index. In the next index what we have the character? Full stop. After that it will place in the next index. Nothing but it is a space. After that it can place the index is placed with the I is placed with here p index. So in that value is p. Like that number of times that cycle will do. How many times? 32 times it can iterate because of 32 characters we have in this string. So the program is over. Now I am saving. So if you want to access individual character in a entire string, so for the in that case we can use the for loops. We can use the for loop function. Individual is my file name and py is extension, dot py is extension. Set save as type is all files. Now I am saving Python to practice problems. So that's why I am clicking on the save button. Now I am executing. So here exit function I am using because of if you want to execute any C file, any Python file, compulsory command prompt we need to use. So before I have connected with Python, so that's why exit of function I have used right now. Now I am in command prompt. So now I am executing. So first I would like to first I want to go that location na. So d colon cd 2021 gprdc cd 2021 cd second bsc python 2 material cd practice problems. Yes, practice programs. Here our file is available. The file name is individual.py. So all of you carefully observe. So the output is printed na. Here the output has printed. Carefully observe. In each individual character it is printing, even including with space character also. So full stop, spaces also. It has accessed individual characters. So entire string it has printed. PG college. All of you carefully observe. Okay na? So like that if you want to access a single character from a string, then for loop is very useful. For loop is very useful. Accessing the individual characters in a string, that concept is also over right now. And for your understanding purpose, I would like to explain one more thing. So name equal to Shiva. So four characters, I mean one string I have configured, that is my name. So if I want to print name, if I want to use the print function along with name variable, so that entire string it will print. If I want to access individual characters, for loop is very useful. Just before I have told you right now. And now here the type is what? How to identify? Is it string or character or any other data type? So for that we have to use type function. We have to use type function. So now I want to know about name variable type. So for that input type function I am using. So in between that functional brackets, that variable I have passed, name variable I have passed. Just I am pressing enter key, it is showing what class str, because of that is a string data type. Because of here I have in between double quotes I have stored that string. Now I want to store character. I want to store character, single character. For that single quotes I have used it, and small a I have assigned it. Now I want to see the type of character string that is also string. Why it is string? Because of here I have stored only one character, na. So in C language, if you want to save any single character, for that character data type we have na char character, char data type, nothing but char data type we have na. So like that in Python, char data type not there. Char data type is avoided because of here it is also treating as a single character string. A string may contain single character, a string may contain a group of character, more than one character. So that is also treated as a string with the length of 1, but with the length of here 4 length can starts with 1. So 1 2 3 4 four characters we have. So this string strength name variable string name variable length is what? 4. The value is 4 characters. Understand? So here also, I mean, char data type is not supported by the Python because of in that not there. Everything is here string data type only can support. Similar to C language, that is the difference between here and that. Python language does not contain any char data type. So here only string data type we have for the strings and characters, alphabets purpose only one data type, that is string data type, str. By using index also, exit of CLS Python. Yeah, here now I am creating one more name variable. In that my name is my name I have stored. So now I want to access. Now I want to print a single character, only single character. So here 4 characters we have. In that third character I am passing third character. What is the third character? That third character I am passing in between square brackets. So now I am pressing enter key. So in the third index, what is the letter we have in the string? So index starts with 0, na. So S is 0, I is 1, V is 2, 3 is A. So A variable, A value printed here because of I just use it. So by using index also, we can print a single characters or single words. Understand? Like that, we can access. So index error also we have to see right now. So here, how many characters we have in the value string, in the string? SIVA, 4 characters. Now I want to print 4th. Is there any 4th value in that string, in that string index? In that string, 4th index we have or not? No, we don't have. So now what it will happen? See right now, just I am pressing enter key. It is showing index error, string index out of range because the 4th index is not there, which is the string we have given with the print function. So in that string, 4th index not there. So that's why string index out of range error it is showing. So compulsory, if we want to see any character in a string, so compulsory within the index range we have to give the index value. So if you give out of index, then it will show the error like this. Next, length function. Now I want to know about the length. So here name equal to Shiva string I have, na. So now I want to know about the length of that string. So for that len function we have in between these two brackets. This is inbuilt function to know about the string length. So that name variable I am passing in between these two brackets. So 4 is the result it is showing as a output because of that name variable values. I mean that name variable value is what? A string. That string contains 4 characters. So that 4 characters length it is counted by length function. And it is showing the length of, it is showing the value of length. I mean, She is showing the value of string. How many characters we have? 4 characters. That 4 characters counting by the length function. So that value it is showing na 4. So the output is 4 like that. So the length function is used to count the length of the function. If you want to find out any length, so any string length or any character's length, compulsory we have to use the length function. That is inbuilt function. So the function is used to, length function is used to find out the length of strings. Next, string concatenation. String concatenation means what? Now I am closing this one. And here, exit of CLS to clear the screen. And now, Python shell window again I am connecting. Carefully observe. Name equal to Shiva. So this is my string. And now, actually I given half name here. Actually my name is what? Complete name is what? Shiva Krishna. And your name is what? For example, now I am clearing this one also. CLS, and again I am connecting the Python. Carefully observe here, student underscore name equal to Pavan. Pavan is name, the student name is Pavan. So now I want I want to assign with initial also. Then student underscore name equal to, carefully observe here what I am doing, in between double quotes, k is initial, so k dot I have used here. After that, one plus operator I am using, and one space I am given, in between double quotes, one space I have given. So without space I can't find, sorry, you can observe here. K dot I have used, and again student name I am using, student underscore name. So the plus operator used to concatenate two strings. If you want to combine two strings, then it is called, for that we can use the plus operator, and this entire process is called string concatenation. Because of here two strings we are assigning as a single strings, two strings we are combining here as a single string. Now I am pressing enter key. Now I am using student underscore name. What it will print? K dot Pavan, right? Na, so initial along with initial it is printed na? It has printed. So in between K dot and here, all of you carefully observe, in between K dot and Pavan immediately it is printing. Now I want to give one space in between these two characters. After full stop I want to give one space character. For that also, here same syntax I am using, one space I am given, again one more plus operator I am using. Here three strings combining as a single string. Now I want to print student name. So again why it is printing? Okay. Okay, here user syntax is wrong. Exit of CLS Python student underscore name. So here Pavan the name, and now I want to give one now along with initial also I want to print. For that student underscore name equal to, so in between double quotes, K dot and plus operator. Now here I want to give one space between these two words. Again I want to give one more plus operator, and student name directly I am using. Here the student name is replaced with, what is the value we have in that previously? Pavan we have. So first K, it will print the K dot. After that it will give one space. and after that it will assign that Pawan value to from here to here. Understand? And diagrammatically I would like to explain what it will happen behind. So first it will generate the this one. What is that value? Pawan. So this is memory. Here is what? Student underscore name. So first it is pointing to here. So this variable is point to here, this value. And here second I am using one more thing, k dot plus plus, I mean k dot plus and one space character plus and student name. Now the value is what here? Student underscore name. So k dot Pawan. Next the value is this one. Because of the string has edited na, k dot space Pawan. So next the variable is same variable we have used na, pointing to this one. So this is going to garbage. This connection has removed. Understand? So freshly, I mean newly, it has point, this variable is pointing to this address. So because of here new value we have updated. So this is the recent value for this variable. So that's why the variable is pointed to here only. So it is going to garbage. It is Python internal, it can treat as a garbage collection value. So I mean there is no use for this variable. So that's why it has deleted, it is going to deleted state. Understand? String concatenation. If you want to create any string, all of you carefully observe. Here I am going to explain one more thing. Strings are immutable objects. Once you created a string, if you want to modify that string, then you need to create one more string also. So previous string we haven't update. Previous string we haven't update. Student name equal to Pawan. So Pawan is the value, name is the variable here. So now I want to add one more. Now I want to add initial also. So for that k dot Pawan we have to use. Then the previously it is pointing to one value, one memory address, and is also one, it is also created with one more address. It is also created one more address. If you want to see that one, simply we can use the id function. Id function is what purpose we can use? Id is the predefined function to know the variable memory address. To know the variable memory address, if you want to see, then for that, in that case, we can use the inbuilt id function. So carefully observe here, name equal to Pawan is first time creation of string. So what is the id of, we can see right now, id of name. So the value is what? 248445486872. So that is memory address of name variable. That is memory address of name variable. So name variable, now I am changing the value. Now I am changing the value k dot Pawan. So now id is name. So 248, all of you carefully observe, 248 248 448 448 548 68 69 272 744. So the last leaf four digits it has changed. So that means it has created with new memory address. So previously it has fixed. Understand? And it is going to garbage also. That string also removed. Because of here updated with this one. Na? So that's why it is immutable objects. Once you created, if you want to modify that previously existed string, it cannot be, I mean, we cannot change. we cannot change because of that has fixed memory address. If you want to assign a new value to that same variable, it will take new memory address. It will create a new place in the memory. It will create new place in the memory. All of you carefully observe. First, it is pointing to this memory, na? So here that value is Pawan. So after that, we have updated with the k dot Pawan. One more extra value we have concatenated. After that, it can place it at where? Some other location. So it is that variable is pointing to this memory address. So that's why it is immutable objects. Immutable means if you want to update this one, then it can be mutable. So here we cannot update, na? Here we cannot change. A new value we have created here. Because of there is no chance to create, there is no chance to edit previous value. Present value, presently I have assigned it with a new value. That means new memory address it has assigned it. If it is pointing to same memory address, then it is mutable. Then it is mutable. Now understand? String concatenation. Yeah, strings are immutable. Already completed. In Python, strings are immutable, which means once they are created, they cannot be changed. Some operations such as concatenation give the impression that they modify strings, but in reality they do not. Same thing I told you right now. So previously I created with the value of Pawan. After that I have updated with k dot Pawan. But the first it is pointing to this memory address and next it is pointing to this memory address. If the variable is pointing to same memory address with same memory address in two times also, after updation and before updation, then it is called mutable. We also can change. But if it is pointing to two memory address, first it is pointing to one memory address and next it is pointing to one more memory address, and previously memory address it is going to delete state. So the fresh value it has stored in that variable, na? So this is called immutable section. The variable is pointing to new memory address. So that is called immutable. Strings are immutable objects. Okay, today I'm going to ending this session. In the next session, I would like to explain about the string slicing concept. So in the lists also we can use the list slicing, and in the tuples also we have used tuple slicing. Like that, strings also we are having to use string slicing. Same process, no change. At least even one word is also one thing also not changeable. Okay, whatever the operations we have done in the list, and what are the operations we have used in the tuples and in the strings also, string slicing is common thing. String slicing concept is common thing for these all concepts. Okay, so in the next class I would like to explain about the string slicing, and today I'm going to ending this session. I hope you enjoyed this entire session, and in the next session I will continue to string part 2. Okay, thank you very much.